we gonna update the motherfucker. Or they was.
Hey, y'all seen Sonic? You seen Sonic and them niggas? You seen Sonic and them niggas had to move a piece on the board. So they seen what Mario and them niggas just stepped outside and did. But I think
Mario get crazy.
Mario number one, man.
I think Sonic and them made a good move though. That was a good move for them to go ahead, yeah, because they're gonna have to open up that world now. They in trouble.
They went back and got Jim.
Nah, they finna do the new TV series with hold on, let me post the article.
That's the wave now, man. After the movie rollout.
Yeah, the series leading up into the third one.
Yeah.
Sonic, man. I'm not scared. Sonic could be as big as Mario. I still ain't gonna let that. I think he could have been. He should have been 1A, 1B to me. Honestly.
I saw the police
out here.
I got
sit
in my car for a little
Sonic, bit. Sonic is for all intents and purposes, Sonic can argue top 10, but he not fucking with Mario.
Nah. Nah, come on, Pujo.
Oh, we talking about video game characters all time.
Hold on.
Get him.
Not finna let these young niggas smut and smear my childhood legacy.
Man, you act like I said niggas fight over something, man.
By saying Sonic is a You said Sonic can argue.
Top 10.
No, I'm saying he can.
I don't like your wording.
He's definitely in the top 10. Yeah, he's definitely in the top 10, man.
The two mistakes that were made was, one, you said argue, and two, you said 10
in the top 10.
By the top 10, what are we doing that by? Cultural impact, to where niggas mimic it.
We're dumb. We need to double.
I'm assuming he was talking just
the character of Sonic being a top 10 character. Is that?
I'd say he's top 5.
Top 5 easily, man. Come on,
that's
bro.
That's why I'm saying 10 is disrespectful to me.
You gotta stop this, bro. That brother know what he's doing, man.
What you mean, man?
That brother know exactly what he's doing right now, man.
I mean, I'm not mad. Well, boom, you don't play video games like that anymore. Respectfully. Or you, Luigi.
No,
when we talk about influential, and if we're influential is different than a character. Like the depth of the character, the storyline, like character progression, nah, I mean, all that shit.
I'm a gamer.
To be serious though, I'm gonna be serious. No. Sonic is definitely a top 5, man. Like it's not none of the debate.
Top 3 pushing it.
You could argue top 3.
I think I got him top 3. Like,
yeah, because you consider who's over him.
Just more
as far as most powerful characters, you got, you know, Pac-Man.
Pac-Man, Mario, Pikachu, fucking
I don't know about Pikachu though, bro. I don't know about Pikachu, but if we have to compare the Sonic, the Pokemon, he is powerful, but I don't know about over Sonic.
Gaming, and we're talking about games now. But
then again, like
gaming.
The thing with Pokemon, yeah, obviously Pikachu is the most iconic character, but there are other Pokemon.
Let me make it clear what I'm saying.
Yeah,
I'm not talking about Pokemon the brand.
Yeah, we did just Pikachu the character.
What I'm talking about is the individual character of Pikachu. I don't believe, and I'm talking about in video games. I don't believe that Pikachu as a video game character, and like Kyle said, I'm long removed from being highly in depth into the video game culture and shit like that, so I definitely want to make sure that that's out there. But I just can't see Pikachu as an individual gaming character more powerful than Sonic. I just can't.
I mean, okay. With that being said, they both are Japanese art forms, like, or Japanese originated characters. Number one. Number two, there is nowhere that you will see Sonic and not see Pikachu.
Where do you want to go?
We could do the main stage.
Hold on, I don't know how to quantify this or how you would actually pull up a study on this, but I would be willing to bet that in the average black household that has adolescent children, there would be more niggas with a Sonic video game in that household
Boom, I want you to reconsider what you just said, because that's a lie. You forgot, when you say adolescent, you mean adolescent in 2023. Did you forget Pokemon Go happened?
Bro, I'm going to stand on what I just said. I don't give a fuck if it's 2023, 2033, or 43. I don't believe that you will see in the black household two parent, one parent, single mama, I don't give a fuck, that has children that are gonna have more Pokemon games in it than a Sonic game. That's just my belief.
You just gotta go to Comic-Con, bro. I never been there, but like, I know that community is deep. Comic-Con is different,
I went to one of them anime things, anime festivals and shit, bro.
Yeah, we're gonna go through these numbers, brothers. We're gonna go through the numbers.
Sonic didn't touch the Pokemon detective movie. We just pulled those stats up earlier today on Tech Thursdays. They're not even close. Not even fucking close. Let me do this. Let me pull up the fucking picture. Cause niggas think I'm fucking playing and think that I just talk out of my ass with it.
Yes, he did.
I don't even know how much.
A better overall character than Pikachu, bro, in the gaming world. We're not doing that, bro.
That's a lie. When you say better character, we're talking about the character, my nigga. We're not talking about influential.
I got a side question while y'all niggas look that up real quick, because it's only going to take 30 seconds. When did this motherfucking Warcraft. This Warcraft movie in 2016.
Yeah.
It wasn't big here. I'm looking at the domestic numbers and I see that.
Yeah, it was huge international.
Okay. That's why it went over my head. I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah, Paula Patton's in that bitch. Boom, watch that.
I seen that movie. I said, all right. Look, I'm going to
check that shit out, because that's second on the list.
What?
You see what I'm saying? These are the five.
Damn.
Now, you want to know what's interesting? You want to know what's interesting? When you look at Sonic's domestic numbers, they're better than Pikachu's domestic numbers. But internationally, Pikachu is bigger than Sonic.
That's why I said, just because it's not powerful to y'all does not make it less powerful.
No, nobody said it ain't powerful. I said in the black household, because niggas ask, where are you going to find that at? I'm specifically dwindling it down to niggas and nigga residences. But I believe anywhere else, low-key, it's going to favor Pokemon. I believe
it. I'm not gonna lie. Sonic doesn't even put out, like, they put out video games, but it's not like that. It's not like that now.
It's not like that now. We're talking about Sonic's prime.
So let's say it's not like that now. 15 years. Let's go back 15 years.
I mean, he was the highest selling video game on Sega for sure. Like,
but I think those domestic numbers kind of
where the fuck was Sega in 2008?
Sonic had a Mario rollout.
No, you said it's Sonic's Prime. You just said Sonic's Prime.
They said Sonic's Prime. I said within the past 15 years.
No, I don't know why anybody would debate that though. In the last 15 years, Sonic. Yeah. Other than the movies, I mean, it ain't.
Yeah, we're talking about Sonic's Prime.
But you said, Boom, you said if we dwindle this thing down to nigga households, that's what I'm saying. There's no kid playing no fucking game from 15 plus years ago. No kid now. There's no kid playing no fucking Pong and shit like that, my nigga. They're playing Fortnite. That's a great point.
So with that point, because you're absolutely right, there is no recent Sonic shit for a nigga. Well, I ain't gonna say that. I don't know that 100%. But
oh, nigga, I enjoy that.
There ain't really nothing recent for niggas to be out buying today of Sonic, as far as video game wise, to my knowledge. But again, I would still think that as opposed to going out and buying a Pokemon game, I don't know if niggas are gonna go out and buy a Pokemon game before they would buy a Sonic. If Sonic was to drop a game
right
now and you match it up with a Pokemon game,
yeah,
and you only had a choice of getting one or the other,
Sonic gonna win that.
I don't know no niggas that's selecting that Pokemon game.
Well, ooh, I mean, it depends on what kind of... I'm not a big fan RPG.
Oh
game.
No, boom.
Wait. Cujo, because I have stats. Cujo, hold on. I got the stats to contest that.
Pokemon Go?
That's what I'm saying. Let me contest this. We're going to do this by quarter with niggas. And this is million. The numbers that I'm going to say are million accurate. Within the fourth quarter of 2022, 10 million niggas were playing Pokemon Go. Quarter three of 2022, 11.4. Second quarter, 11.36. Quarter one, 11. Quarter four of 2021, 12.5. Three of 21, 16.5. Quarter two, 21, 12.05. Quarter one of 2021, 12.4. Quarter four of 2020, that's 15 million. Quarter three of 2020, that's 17.2 million.
This is niggas, quarter though? Two.
This is people playing the game. You're not this really allowed. You're not allowed to do it like that. Like, you can't.
No, I am. That was
you legally can't do that. Yeah, you can't legally be like, these are the black downloaders. You legally can't do that. On a business.
Negroes, man.
So we can't find that.
I don't know how we gonna quantify that or how you can prove that. I said that in the very beginning. But that's again, fair. When I look at the domestic numbers, now obviously movies is completely different than video games. So I don't want niggas to think that I'm leaning solely off of that. But when I see Sonic pull in a domestic revenue $50 million greater than Pokemon,
that's 2023 money too.
And that was also because you have to realize, boom, what happened with that Sonic situation. We talked about it earlier in Tech Thursday. Shout out to us, Wave and Blaze, Is We Poddin, that type of shit. We talked about, like, when the first trailer of Sonic came out, the Twitter community bullied a fucking production company.
Yeah, they had to revise it a bunch of times.
Yes, because how they initially saw it, niggas was like, this shit is ass pussy. They found the niggas' real Twitter, boom. The CGI niggas, they found their real @boom3000 ATL nigga. They found that. It was at niggas every day. Every other hour, this is ass. Thousands of ads. And they changed it. They put the shit on back order for 6 months to a year. And then they put it out after they revised it. So everybody went to see it, to see the end result of that. Yeah, that shit, that has to be taken into consideration when you look at the numbers, my nigga. Yeah, I'm not justifying niggas not doing the same numbers, but internationally, when you take everything into effect, nigga, Pokemon, the Pikachu shit dwarfs the Sonic shit badly. It's not even fucking close.
But my argument is not internationally, but like, we know that though, or niggas should know that.
Niggas should.
You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about niggas, man. I ain't
talking about them other the niggas in Paris and niggas in Taiwan. I'm talking about niggas. I'm talking about the niggas that was brought over on the boats, man. The niggas in the United States, man. I'm talking about the niggas, man. I don't know too many niggas.
The niggas.
And they kids that's going to run. Now, I'm not denying that they play. I'm not denying that they play that shit.
Right.
But just the nostalgia of Sonic from the parent brought down to the child. And clearly how relevant Sonic still is today when you look at these box office numbers. I just can't see the fucking day where a nigga would choose a Pokemon game over fucking Sonic.
I'm gonna be petty.
They make better games, you know.
I'm gonna find a day next week. Boom. I'm gonna be very fucking petty. I'm gonna go down to Linux and I'm gonna do a survey with Linux. I'm gonna go down to Linux. I'm gonna do a survey. All right. I'm gonna stop at 100 niggas.
That'll be interesting.
But is
that'll be fire. I might record that shit, put it up on the pod. I'm gonna do a survey.
That's content right there.
Yeah, that's content, Lucci. This isn't the earlier part of our shit wasn't content. Like,
yeah, you better delete that. Actually, upload that on the YouTube. Upload that.
Nah,
don't do that.
Please do. Please don't. Because I don't want us to be involved in any media.
Nah, yeah, don't do that.
Shit. Like, please don't do that.
Nah, K, you're right, man. Mario definitely, for sure, number one, like, overall.
Clear top dog. Like, that should never be. That should, like, he clearly showed when I come outside, all the rest of you little niggas that was doing, that was eating, y'all niggas, I let y'all niggas eat. what that nigga,
man, all you little Pikachu niggas.
I try to let you pussy niggas eat.
You little Pikachu niggas, Sonic, Pac-Man, and all them, man.
I let you niggas eat.
Yeah, man.
Now it's my turn.
That shit still goes into the same pocket that the Pikachu money goes into. That's still a Japanese shit.
Oh, that's a fact.
Man, I didn't make but fucking
y'all let it. And I blame you, older nigga, Lucci, because you talking. You get shot first.
Boom. Yeah, what up?
Boom. You get shot second. Boom. Because you older nigga. Who else older in here? Ty, you muted. You get shot too, nigga. Y'all let a Japanese nigga do an Italian character and sell it to Americans and then say
hold up, hey brother, I'm just listening. Don't do your audience like that, man. I'm just
he wasn't even Italian, bro. They got Chris Pratt to do that, bro. I was like,
no, Mario's Italian. Mario is Italian.
Yeah, Mario is
an Italian plumber from New York.
Hold on, we
from America, we ain't to blame. Them niggas over in Japan. them niggas over in Asia. Done went out and supported the shit. And got it breaking all types of records. So, hey.
Right. Them niggas made the character, man. An Italian plumber from New York, man.
I'm like, bro, he sound like.
Really?
Wait, that's cultural appropriation?
Badly.
Agabagoo.
No, Cujo, stop being reserved. If we had a nigga from Georgia, shout out to Marabi's peoples, we had a nigga from Georgia write a story about hood niggas in Georgia, America, Georgia, and sell it to niggas, that would be cultural appropriation, wouldn't it?
Fact.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I thought so. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What it is surely a, is. But what surely is a more like recognizable character than Sonic?
That's how powerful Mario is. I got a nigga that don't even look or sound like me. Voicing me, and we still out here shattering shit.
Mario powerful, man. Mario definitely number one. Like, it ain't even, not even up for debate, man.
I don't like see niggas eat, man.
Yeah, they shout out to Nintendo. Nintendo really got
it. You know, it's crazy. The nigga started off being a Donkey Kong's flunky for real, man. Like, and the nigga just passed the nigga. Like, nigga waited his time. Like, yeah, man, we get it, man. Donkey and all that with the hoes. We get it, man. I'm going to surpass you, nigga.
With the hoes.
It's that, man. Yeah, his only friend.
I'm gonna do a character dick. That nigga Naruto, that nigga Mario, really a cuck. Badly. The nigga lets another nigga take his bitch every couple months, just to go fight some of that nigga's niggas to get his bitch back, just to get his bitch took again. He's a cuck. That's what he is.
Man, he act like Bowser fucking Peaches or something. Man, he ain't not fucking.
I don't know if he is or I don't know. Nigga,
he's just kidnapping
know
her, man, every once in a while.
Hey, yo, you know.
You got some of that pussy in the movie, Cujo.
Yo, you know what I just.
Exactly.
I'm sorry. Can't look at
you. You can hear about the Peaches song? Come on, man. Read between the lines, bro. Stop this shit.
Yo,
man.
Lucy, I'll
stop this, man. I got some of that pussy.
Peaches.
Yeah, yeah. I was there, man. Shout out my nigga Luigi, man. Luigi don't get recognized enough, man.
Shout out to Luigi, bro.
Definitely right. Fuck with my nigga Luigi.
You know what I'm saying? I fake fuck with Wario too, man, for whatever reason. I don't know why, man. I fuck with Wario too, man.
No, that's why Sonic and them niggas in trouble. Shit, the rest of the video game world is in trouble because once they bring Wario into the... Wario got his own...
That's his a fact.
Own cult, separate art.
His own cult following. So once they bring his ass into the fold, yeah.
Wario, one of the niggas, man.
Wait, who doing the series? Sonic doing the series? A show?
I believe so. Yeah, yeah.
Dang. Yeah. Mario made them come outside.
Shout out Waluigi too, man. That nigga is formidable. I mean, I for years.
Real nigga. Real nigga, Cujo. That's who I used to play with on Mario Party and fucking Double Dash and shit like that. Waluigi, real nigga.
Fact.
Real nigga. Stop playing with my man.
The thing is, though, with Sonic, y'all was talking about as far as the video games, he's done reached such a high plateau that by the time Sonic peaked, it really didn't matter for real, to be honest. Like, it didn't have so many powerful video games. All right, man, we still gonna fuck with this, like, despite whatever, like, so all that, like, Sonic Rings, and even though it didn't really do the best, like, critically, it was still selling, like, you know, wild numbers. You know, because Sonic one of them niggas, man. Like, so it is what it is. And it's not like his older fans are the ones that's keeping him alive. Like, somehow he's able to stay relevant throughout all generations, you know what I'm saying? And still reintroduce himself to this new generation. I know this nigga's, like, 5-6 years old. That don't really know who Sonic is at all. Or maybe then you got 10-year-olds or 11-year-olds that grew up on their pops or their uncle playing Sonic. You know what I'm saying? They got familiar with the character by, you know, maybe watching the anime or whatever the case. So yeah, Sonic being able to do that is pretty dope. So
to make a fucking hedgehog popular is not a small task.
Yeah, fucking hedgehog, man. Yeah, I go like that is crazy, man.
In the era that they did it, crazy. Yeah,
blue hedgehog, nigga don't even look like a hedgehog at all, man. They done redesigned the nigga to stand up and shit. Like, I mean, I don't know. But we talk about fire video game characters so much. Like, y'all got any niggas y'all think are ass? Like.
Hold on. Before we do that, Cujo, I said the joint earlier today. There's a Samus movie coming out.
Samus from Metroid Prime?
Yeah. That's long getting over.
Yeah,
I think it's like 2 years from now. 2 years from now, I think. But they like leaked the like the concept art. Yeah, concept art. That's what it's called. Yeah, and that shit's gonna be fire. That nigga Luigi's a pussy.
No, he always been a bitch.
He had a whole video game based on that, man. Nigga scared of ghosts. Yeah. Grown ass man.
Yeah, Luigi's a pussy. Who's another video game character that feels a pussy? The fucking what's the nigga's name? We were just talking about Donkey Kong earlier. Fucking Diddy Kong is a pussy. I know niggas like the fitted. That nigga's a pussy.
Come on, man.
He is.
Shout out Diddy Kong, man.
That nigga a child playing in grown folks' business. Like, he's a pussy. Stop. Fucking, what's my man's name? Fucking,
I said worst video game. Can I say the most pussy, man?
Oh, work? My bad. Well, it's the same list. I'm not gonna lie. Worst goes to my man's from Vice City. GTA Vice City. He falls into that. Terrible character. Terrible fucking character.
Hey, I ain't gonna lie, I was never a fan of this game. But if they drop this game, it might rival all that shit.
Oh.
If they do a Legend of Zelda.
Oh, my nigga Link.
With the boy Link.
Yeah. Link powerful too, yeah.
They do that shit the right way.
You right. Oh, damn, you right. Oh.
That Legend of Zelda shit, man.
Duh.
Yeah, that nigga powerful, man. Link is definitely powerful. For the longest, I call that nigga Zelda for the longest. The black community as a whole always call that nigga Zelda. I don't call that nigga Link at all.
That nigga powerful.
And especially if you do a movie based off of Breath of the Wild. That was a super high selling game. God damn.
I don't even know all the in-depths of the storylines. I just know that nigga powerful.
He for sure is powerful.
That shit would be crazy. I don't even play their games like that. I can't hold you. I don't even play that shit like that.
I would be more interested in, way more interested watching it on screen than actually ever playing the game.
Boom, I got one better. I see what you brought to the table. I'm a raise you. Kratos from God of War would be a fire movie.
Yeah,
that would be a fire fucking movie.
I could see
want that to be a series, honestly.
Would it be more powerful than Zelda?
Nah, because he's not as powerful of a character.
See, the only reason why I don't think it would be more powerful than, I think it would be extremely powerful. Let me not get that confused. But the reason why I don't think it would be as powerful as Zelda is because of the timeline that Zelda covers and the age range of gamers or just people who are familiar with Zelda goes back all the way to motherfuckers that's 45, 50 years old right now.
Right.
Yeah, he's a legacy. He's a legacy act. Mm-hmm.
He's a legacy act. Exactly.
Kratos not there yet. It's going to take a couple more years. You know, so he top 20, I would argue. I'm not going to lie.
Correct me if I'm wrong, Cool Joe. Didn't the first God of War game come out in like the mid 2000s? Like 2005? Thank you.
He working with about 15 years strong?
18. Boom, it's 2023, bro.
Yeah,
you got
damn near 2 decades, damn near. You know what I'm saying?
That nigga Zelda about what?
Shit, 3 or 4?
30? He's 30.
You got shit going on like the SNES.
Yeah,
from SNES and Nintendo to
internationally.
To the Wii. Yeah, literally every generation. Yeah, so
crazy. I like that idea.
If
they did do God of War, though, Cuff from 300, Gerald Butler I could definitely see him doing that shit. He would kill that shit. I think.
What is Kratos?
Yeah.
Hold on, ain't Kratos bald? Ain't he a bald head nigga?
Yeah, he a bald.
In more ways than one, he's literally a bald headed nigga. He was voiced by black men for the most part of his career.
Yeah, he was literally voiced by black men. Living single and shit.
My nigga Overton?
No, the dark skin nigga. With the locks. Yeah. That was him early on. That was him.
Shit.
And then it was another black man who did the most recent game as well. Mind you, he got like a slick back hairdo and everything. Bro, that's a bald head nigga. Yes. That's a nigga.
Damn.
Very.
Yeah.
I wonder what type of bread my nigga from Living Single got stupid. Back up.
Yeah.
Stupid. The nigga got in one of the interviews, boom, he said he doesn't feel the need to work anymore.
Okay.
Because of the shit off of God of War.
I hope he got what he deserved.
My nigga, if I get 300K a year in residuals, boom, I know that's not crazy. The niggas, boom, no, I'm not working. Yeah, I'm not working. Are you crazy? Yeah. Fuck that.
Nah, 300 is more than enough.
Yeah, a year? Yeah, I'm definitely, yeah.
Something fucking ridiculous. Because he did 3 games, I think, if I remember correctly. He did 3 games.
I definitely never knew that.
Yeah, it was him. And they were trying to get, he has the most pausedest name ever on Twitter. Keith David. They were trying to get Keith David. His Twitter handle and shit like that is the Silver Throat, which is wild. Why would you? That's crazy. But they wanted Keith David badly. And Keith David would have been a dope Kratos. Dope. Mm. That would have been like, oh shit, like this nigga means business. But like they couldn't work that shit out. And then Keith David thought that Saints Row was a better investment than God of War. Made a bad decision. That happens.
I don't even know much about all that new shit, but I definitely know that game.
Yeah, the shit fire, bro.
Hey, I think the shit is recording, but it ain't a conversation ended up going somewhere else, so it ain't gonna be
it's not gonna be bad.
It ain't gonna be put out, so you could talk, nigga.
Yeah, you good, Dot. You good. What did Dave say? Dave added me. Hold on. See.
Right. Nah, but I'm pretty sure the Mario shit now then opened up their eyes to like, okay, like they know their characters that they got. Like Nintendo, that Zelda movie coming. I promise you.
Yeah, I can see that shit happening. Yeah, I could definitely, yeah.
Isn't Spyro Nintendo as well? Hold on.
Nah, I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't think Spyro Nintendo.
Cause he was mainly on the PlayStation platform.
Yo.
So. Yeah, we hear you. We got you.
Okay. Spyro was cool, man. I never really thought Spyro was.
Spyro, the little purple dragon, nigga.
Yeah.
Ah, you tripping, nigga? Spyro was fire.
He was cool, man.
No, that was.
Okay. He was powerful in video game format. I don't know how that shit would translate on.
My bad. We're never getting a Spyro movie. Never mind. I see who owns it. Never mind. It's over. It's over. Activision owns Spyro. It's not happening. It's over.
He ain't no Crash Bandicoot, but you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. We like B tier, you know what I'm saying? man.
He definitely B tier.
Yeah.
I mean, come on, man. He's not. Sonic is not over. Stop it, man. He's not doing it, man.
Nah,
man, he's always trying to be controversial, man.
Man, why are you doing this?
He's not over Mario, brother. Be realistic, man.
I mean, I personally fuck with Sonic more, but he's not over Mario, though.
Yeah, my biasness. Yeah, I have Sonic.
I'm not mad at that. Yeah, I'm not mad.
they fucked up my dog Sonic, man. My dog Sonic supposed to be out there 1A and 1B, man. Him and Mario, bro. They fucked him up.
Bro, he back. Man.
They dropped the ball with Sonic.
He back. What you mean drop the ball? He
nah,
back.
He didn't drop the ball. He ain't as powerful as he could have been, bro. That's what I'm telling.
Them kids love that dude.
They dropped the ball, my dog, man.
I mean, Sonic done had TV shows, you know what I'm saying?
He's Jim Carrey too, man.
Yeah, man, you know. I mean, he is technically. I mean, okay. We already said who's over Sonic against Pac-Man.
Nah, you said that, nigga.
Pac-Man is over that nigga, man. As far as overall,
I'm gonna say that.
If we're talking about overall, yeah, I don't got him over Sonic, but yeah, he over that nigga, man.
Nah, he a more iconic character for sure.
Who else could be over Sonic, man? If you're trying to argue top five, I mean, shit. Let me just see, man.
So what you got? Mario, Pac-Man, and what you working on the rest?
Yeah, I'm trying to see, man. Niggas.
I mean, low key.
Oh.
That nigga Link, low key. Like.
Yeah.
You got an argument.
Yeah. Well. Yeah,
that nigga been just as relevant for longer.
That's true, yeah.
I don't agree, but shit, motherfuckers love that nigga.
Trying to see, man. I'm trying to see.
And the only three, like, and you know, even though I don't think he is bigger, I mean, you could Pikachu as well. You know what I'm saying? Got an argument. I think that's the four right there.
Yeah.
Okay,
the Scorpion.
As far as top 10,
they've been around for a minute.
I mean, yeah, and there's so many of them. I mean, you'd have to see who's most relevant of all of them. There's so many MK characters, man. Like, who the most popular, like, of all them niggas? Like, you got Luke.
To me, the most popular is either Scorpion or Sub Zero. It's not even Luke. It's gonna take some older niggas to really come out the woodwork and say Liu Kang, like
Scorpion that nigga.
Scorpion is that nigga.
Bad.
He's that nigga. Ain't that last little bullshit ass movie they just dropped even centered like
Around
Scorpion? Around, yeah. What's my nigga? Sub-Zero and Scorpion. I pulled that shit up earlier today when I was on the podcast earlier, because we were talking about all this shit. Video games, movies, da-da-da-da. Nigga, you know the Mortal Kombat shit from 2021 didn't even make $100 million?
No, that shit was terrible.
With a budget of 50-something million, them niggas made 84.4 million?
That shit was terrible.
I know, but the film property is supposed to carry a lot of the video game shit. You see what I'm saying? It's not about the content of the movie, my nigga. With these shits, specifically. Like, that's why I'm still barking on niggas about the fucking D&D movie. Badly. These niggas beat John Wick, boom, in the same weekend.
Who? Dungeons & Dragons?
Yes. They beat John Wick.
I was expecting a lot from them niggas.
Yeah, I know you was, nigga.
And I ain't even no D&D nigga.
Nah, they didn't beat John Wick. They beat, when John Wick first dropped, it was number one in the box office. And then I think
over the weekend, it was over the weekend. Over the weekend, they beat him.
Oh, okay.
Period. Like, over the, because, yeah, when they dropped on different days. They didn't drop the same day. But when it came down to it actually being like, where niggas actually do them numbers, boom. It's over the weekend, my nigga. If you drop a movie on Wednesday, niggas don't start counting shit until the weekend. Over the weekend, boom, they beat niggas. Clearly. Almost like 10 million or something like that. Just beat niggas. Just look at nobody said anything.
Look at the total box office for Dungeons and Dragons, because Ankh was one of the believers who said it was going to do 100 million.
I thought I was going to hit 100.
I don't think it's at 100 million.
It's so
I had 100. I already checked.
It did 38 and a half opening weekend.
I was expecting the nurse to stand up. No nurse. No nurse stayed in the house.
It is a good movie, though, from what I hear. Like, critically, it's a good movie.
They spent $150 million on that movie?
Ooh. Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, supposed to be three.
And a lot of that went to consulting shit and making sure the CGI didn't look like Marvel CGI. Yeah, that's where a lot of that
went. Damn.
And what's his face isn't cheap either. You know the nigga.
Who the lead Chris nigga? Pine.
Chris Pine. Yep. He's not cheap. Like, yeah, that money was going to good places. It's a good movie. I told you, Boom, and I told you, Cujo. Even if you don't play D&D like that, like, off of it just being a movie, it's like, oh, this shit cool. It's a cool movie. Like, it's better than fucking, what did niggas just release to niggas? Fucking, what was the, damn, I haven't watched that shit in a while. Fucking, what was the Marvel joint? I felt it was better than Black Panther.
What you talking about?
You said what? My bad.
What movie you talking about?
I said I felt like it was better than Black Panther 2.
Oh, you talking about Dungeons and Dragons?
Yeah, yeah. I felt like it was a better movie than Black Panther 2. Like, I rated it higher. Period. Like, I think I said, like, Black Panther 2 was like a 7.5. Maximum 8 if you want to reach, and I said like Dungeons and Dragons was like an 8.5 up to like 9 maybe, just as a movie. If you're a nigga who doesn't know shit and you sit down and watch it, that's how I'm written. No, it was a good, it was a good movie, bro. Very fucking good movie. So that shit's cool. What was the joint that niggas just tried to, I can't remember the DC joint niggas just tried to force on. Goddamn.
DC movie recently?
Yeah. No, Shazam? I'm sorry. That was a. Yeah, Shazam. Thank you. That was Shazam.
Shazam was fucking so much, man.
It came out.
Yeah,
I ain't hear
my
motherfucker.
That nigga's so ass, bro.
Fucking terrible.
Superman fucking copycat, man.
It was better than Shazam and Black Adam. That's who I was trying to remember as well. Black Adam was fucking terrible.
Yeah, man.
And y'all niggas let The Rock come into y'all franchise. Like, why would y'all let this cancerous nigga do that shit? And we all wanted to see fucking Black Adam.
Stop. Hopefully, yeah, they redeem themselves with The Flash. In another Batman movie. I know that.
You think they're gonna redeem themselves with Ezra Miller?
The movie, man. We're not talking about the movie, man. I fuck with the Flash.
That shit's gonna be terrible, but okay. I can respect you all now. I can respect you. Respect it.
Hey, whatever happened, that shit gonna break the box office. Shout out
my nigga's definitely gonna watch it for sure.
Shout out my nigga Michael Keaton, man.
Yeah, they got both Batmans in that bitch, man. They got the Ben Affleck, in that bitch.
Fucking Keaton.
And they got Michael Keaton, man.
That's all. Look.
I got your pansy lip Keaton in that motherfucker.
Shout out to Michael Keaton as well. He was in the Spider-Man joint as well. Shout out to him. He ain't got no brand loyalty. You see what I'm saying? He really easy to block Captain on. He gonna go with a check take. Shout out to him. Real nigga. Real nigga.
Man, he's on the slide, man. Free agent, man. It is what it is.
Damn.
Brother unsigned, man.
No, I don't think they're going to get rid of the boy Ezra, though, because...
They definitely not.
I mean, it sound good. You know what I mean? They going to tell the people that, because if you tell people otherwise, nigga, you're not going to fuck up the rollout of the film. So they're going to ride the wave of, yeah, we getting rid of the nigga. Don't worry about it. Blase, blase, blah. Soon as that bitch start to approach 800, 900 mil globally, they gonna break the news to niggas like, well, we don't know if it's financially in our best interest to swap out.
Niggas beyond that already. The niggas knew that they weren't cutting that nigga off when they let him do the fucking movie, boom. Because he did all that extra shit around the same time they were filming the movie. So the fact that you releasing the movie still is like, you don't give a fuck about none of that. You ain't fooling nobody with a good eye, my nigga. Meanwhile, Marvel doing this situation with fucking Jonathan Majors. And I'm not supporting it. I'm not supporting niggas putting hands on women. I don't support that. Shit's weird. Just simply saying.